Hey kids, once again it's Mr. Thaddaeus from Hope Christian Church, back with another great Bible lesson. I hope you've had a great week. You know, I've had a great week. So let's get into this Bible lesson. You ready to go? Let's go. Today's Bible lesson is Job Trusts God. The Bible scripture is Job chapter 1, Job chapter 2, Job chapter 38 verses 1 through 3, Job chapter 42 verses 1, verses 2, and verses 10 through 17. The Bible focus is we should trust God even when bad things happen. And the Bible memory verse is Psalms chapter 25, verse 5. Okay, before we do anything else, you know we got to do three things. The first thing we need to do is we need to get rid of all the distractions. I need you to turn your Nintendo Switch off, turn it off your Xbox One, your PS5, turn off your laptop, turn off your TV, turn off your cell phone, unless you're watching this video on the cell phone. Second thing I need you to do is I need you to get your mother, your father, your brother, your sister, your grandma, your grandfather, everybody that's in the house, say, hey, Mr. Thaddaeus is back with another awesome Bible lesson, and I think you should hear it. The third thing you should do is get your Bible. Guess what? I got my Bible, and I'm going to give you 10 seconds to get it. You ready? Let's go. Alright, you've got your Bible. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for this lesson, Lord God. Father God, we thank you for an awesome week we just had, Lord God, and we're ready to learn, Lord God, why we should trust you. So Father God, I pray that the ears and eyes and hearts will be open to the lesson and the message you have today. In the name of Jesus, amen. Okay, so before we get started, I have a joke for you, because you know Mr. Thaddaeus, he's got jokes. Here's a joke. Why was 6 afraid of 7? Why was 6 afraid of 7? Well, I'll tell you why 6 was afraid of 7. 6 was afraid of 7 because 7 ate 9. Get it? The number 6, the number 7, and 8, and he ate 9. 6 is 8. Okay, all right. That's enough of the jokes. All right, let's get a lesson. Today we're going to talk about money. Everybody knows what money is. You use money to buy things you need. Some people have a lot of money, like the owner of Amazon, Jeff Bezos. He's the richest man in the world, I guess, depending on the day. And some people don't have a lot of money. You know, you need money to buy things. Some people, especially in today's society, judge you based on how much money that you have. But money can't buy you everything. And let's name some things that are really important and valuable to us that money can't buy. First thing I think about is your health. Money can't buy you good health. When you're in bad health, yes, you can go to the doctor, you can go to the hospital. But when you're not in good health, you know, you have all the money in the world, but you're not in good health. The second is good friends. Money can't buy you friends. They can't. Money can't buy friends. So, you know, some people will be your friend even if you don't have any money. And you always have to be a little bit wary and leery of people who are your friends only because you have money. And the third thing that money can't buy is God's love. No matter how much money you have, you cannot buy God's love. You cannot buy your salvation. So today we're going to find out what happens when a rich man in the Bible lost almost everything he had. We'll learn today that we should trust God even when bad things happen. All right, let's get ready. Grab your Bible. I want you to open your Bible to the book of Job. We're going to turn to chapter 1. Before we get started, is the book of Job in the Old Testament or the New Testament? If you think it's in the Old Testament, raise your right hand. If you think it's in the New Testament, raise your left hand. If now you're afraid of the number 7 because he ate 9, raise both hands. The book of Job is in the Old Testament. Right-hand people, way to go. Left-hand people, better luck next time. If you're afraid of the number 7, I don't know what to tell you. All right, so open your book, the book of Job, your Bible. I'm going to read verses 1 through 3. verse 1. Job was a man who lived in us. He was honest inside and out, a man of his word, who was totally devoted to God and hated evil with a passion. All right, so let's get into today's lesson. I want you to pay attention because I may have a couple questions afterwards. All right, so Job had great respect for God. He did what was right in God's eyes. Job had a wife, 7 sons, and 3 daughters. In Bible time, you could tell that a person was rich by the number of animals he owned and by the number of servants that he had and who worked for him. So Job owned 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 pairs of oxen, and 500 donkeys. He had many servants. Job was the richest man in the land. So one day disaster struck. Awful things began to happen. When Job's sons and daughters were having a feast, a messenger ran to Job and said, "An enemy has attacked. Your oxen and donkeys have all been taken, and many of your servants were killed." That's pretty bad. While that messenger was still telling Job the bad news, another messenger ran to Job. That messenger said, "Fires burned up your sheep and the servants were with them." That's pretty bad. Then a third messenger came and brought more bad news. So the messenger said, "Enemies attacked. They stole your camels and killed your servants." Then a fourth messenger came and brought the worst news of all. He said, "Job, as your sons and your daughters were having a feast and eating together, a mighty wind blew. The house fell down, killed all your sons and daughters. Only Job and his wife were left." Job was very sad, you can understand. He tore his robe and shaved his head to show how upset he was. But Job didn't blame God for all the bad things that had happened. In fact, Job worshiped God. He prayed and said he knew that God is the one who gives and takes away everything. That wasn't the end of Job's problems. Job got sores all over his body, from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. He was in great pain. It hurt a lot. Job's wife wanted Job to quit believing in God and give up. But Job said, "If we accept the good things from God, we should accept trouble too." That's very interesting. It's a very deep thought. Job didn't blame God for all the bad things that had happened. Job trusted God. While Job was still in pain, 3 friends came. The friends wanted to make Job feel better, so they sat quietly with Job. And Job talked honestly with his friends about everything that happened. He wanted to know why the things happened the way that they happened. But Job never blamed God and never stopped believing in God. But you know, talking to his friends didn't really help much because his friends didn't have the answers to the questions that he was asking. Then Job talked and listened to God. Talking with God did help. Job remembered that God can do all things. Which he can. God can do all things. It's a great thing to remember. God was pleased with Job. So God gave Job even more than he had before. God gave Job 14,000 sheep, 6,000 camels, 1,000 pairs of oxen, and 1,000 donkeys. God gave Job 7 more sons and 3 more daughters. Job lived a long life. He loved and trusted God. That's a great story. That's one of my top 10 Bible stories. Job's very interesting. That's a very good story. Very good lesson for us. Okay, so you've heard the lesson. I hope you've been paying attention. Now it's time for my often imitated, never duplicated game called Amen or Uh-huh, where I ask you a fact about the Bible lesson we just heard, and if that fact is true, you nod your head and you'll say amen. If that fact is not true, you shake your head and say, "Uh-uh, that's not true." You ready? Let's go. All right. In the old days, you can tell, the Bible days, how rich a person was by the number of animals that a person had and the number of servants that worked for him. Job was a very poor person. Amen or uh-huh. Nope, that's not true. Job was a rich person. As we heard, Job had 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 pairs of oxen, 500 donkeys, and he had a lot of servants working for him. So Job was a rich man. All right, so while Job's sons and daughters were having a feast, He got 4 visits from messengers. And each messenger came and told him good news to say, hey, Joe, we just found a bag of money behind your house. And the second one said, hey, Joe, guess what? You know, I found 4 more camels wandering around. And then the third one said, hey, Joe, guess what? You know, I found 4 guys that want to work for you, so you have more service. And then the fourth guy said, hey, Joe, guess what? Your kids are having a feast, and they brought you a plate of food. Amen. That's not true. That's not true. He got 4 messengers, one after another, gave him bad news. They did not give him good news. All right. Next fact. After Job heard all that news, Job was sad, and guess what he did? He tore his clothes, he shaved his head, and he blamed God. He was mad at God. Amen or uh-uh. That's not true. That's not true. Job did not blame God for the things that had happened. He actually worshiped God. He knew that God was a person that gave you good stuff and gave you bad stuff. All right, so Job didn't blame God. His wife wanted him to blame God. Job said he wouldn't blame God. Job's friends came over, trying to make him feel better. That didn't work. And then finally, Job talked to God. And God talked back to Job. He listened, amen or uh-uh. Amen, that's true. After all of that, Job talked to God. God talked back, and Job listened to God. Amen. That's true. All right. Final fact. After all of that, when Job, not listening to his wife, not blaming God, talking to God, listening to God, God was pleased with Job. Amen. Amen. God was pleased with Job. He ended up giving him more than what we had before. And he ended up giving Job 7 more sons and 3 more daughters. All right, that's amen or uh-uh. Very good. Very good. Give yourself a round of applause. That was a really hard one, but you paid it and you hung in there. Next is a Bible memory verse. A Bible memory verse comes from Psalm chapter 25, verse 5. I'm going to read it, and then I'm going to read a part. You repeat after me, and then we're going to say it together, okay? Psalm chapter 25, verse 5. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God my Savior, and my hope is in you all day long. All right, I'm going to say a part, you say a part. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God my Savior, and my hope is in you all day long. All right, now we're going to say it together. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God my Savior, and my hope is in you all day long. All right, that's it. That's the Bible lesson. Let's pray. Bow your head and close your eyes. Father God, we thank you for this example, Job, Lord God, that showed that even when bad things happen, Lord God, we should still trust you, still worship you, Lord God. And we can talk to you, and you'll talk back to us, Lord God. So, Father God, we pray you give us a heart to trust you, Lord God, and communicate with you, Lord God. And we'll remember that, Lord God, for the rest of our lives. We thank you for your son, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, amen. All right, before we leave, we got 3 things to do, 3 really quick things to do. First thing I need you to do, I need you to like this video, give it a thumbs up, whatever that means. Like this video. The second thing I need you to do, I need you to share this video with 3 people. I know you know 3 people will be blessed by this lesson. Ask your parents first. And the third thing I need you to do, I need you to decide to trust God even when bad things happen. Okay? This is Mr. Thaddaeus from Hope Christian Church. I hope you enjoyed this Bible lesson. I'll see you next time. Bye.